Hey there, my name's Drew Brashler, and in this video, I'm going to be showing you how to connect an iPod or a computer to your Behringer X32. If you're brand new to my channel, I'm all about helping you feel more confident in your production gear no matter where you're starting from. So let's go ahead and dive in. Now, I typically connect an iPod or a computer to my Behringer X32 to use for playback of music for my walk-in and walk-out portions of my event or service. And on an iPod and a computer or laptop or really anything, there's always going to be a headphone jack. And that headphone jack is an 1/8 inch TRS connection, which means that there is a right and a left and a ground in that connector. Now, if you take a 1/8 inch TRS and plug it into an XLR adapter and just have a single mono source, it's actually not going to play both the right and the left side of the music into your Behringer X32, which is a problem. So if you're ever connecting a laptop or a music device to your X32, you do need to take up two channels because there's a left and a right. So that is stereo. Now there's a bunch of different ways that we can actually connect this up to our Behringer X32. And the easiest way is the way that I do this most often if I'm just using an iPod is I get an 1/8 inch to RCA connector that's just this. So we have our 1/8 inch and then we have our RCA jacks and we can actually utilize the RCA inputs on our aux ins on the back of the board right here. So I would plug my white into the white on the aux in and my red into the red. And then we would just plug this into my iPod. Start some music here. And then we can go over to my aux layer and we can see that on aux 5 and 6, we have our music playing. Now, one thing to note about the aux ins on the back of your console is there is also a 1/4 inch TRS input on the back of the console. So you can actually plug in something into the TRS and have it play into the same channel while this iPod is playing into the RCA inputs on the back of the board, which is actually pretty cool. Now, the only thing that you'll have to do is you'll have to vary the volume on your two devices rather than the gain here on the console, because if we select our aux, there is only one gain knob. So it would be playing the gain of both of those on the same channel. So one thing to do if you are setting this up for a stereo playback is you would want to select your aux 5. And then you would want to go ahead and link these two channels and confirm. And that way, if we raise this up, it is going to play them back together and move them together. The other benefit is it will automatically pan the left to the left side and the right to the right side. Now, what are some other ways that we can connect our device up to our board? Well, another way of doing it is to have a 1/8 inch TRS to stereo XLRs. So this is going to separate my 1/8 inch TRS into two separate XLRs. And we can utilize this for plugging in into our XLR inputs. So let me go ahead and plug this in into input 1 and 2 of my board. And we can simply plug this into our device and we can press play. And then go to channels 1 and 2. And if I select these two, I would want to link them. And now we have our playback happening on channels 1 and 2. Now, if you're plugging in your device and it's going over a very long distance with this cable, this is an unbalanced cable, meaning that any noise that is around this device electrically would go into this cord and into your mixer. So that's not going to be beneficial for a long distance run. So if you're going anywhere longer than, say, 3 feet, I would recommend using a direct box like this. Now, this happens to be an active stereo direct box. Now, the benefit of this is it has a bunch of inputs here. So it has an 1/8 inch, it has 1/4 inch, and it even has my RCA jacks. On the back side of this, we have two XLRs. So I would just simply grab two XLR cables, connect them here, send it to my inputs 1 and 2, or whatever inputs you want to use on your board, and then we would just have this work through the direct box. Now, the benefit of using the XLRs for long distance is those are going to be a balanced cable, which means any noise that's subjected into that cable is going to be canceled out because of the balanced nature of an XLR cable. So if we wanted to go ahead and connect this up, all I would do is disconnect this cable, grab two XLRs, and then connect this between our DI box and our console. Now, there are a couple different types of direct boxes, and the main two is going to be active and passive DI boxes. So this happens to be an active DI box, which means that I need to apply phantom power so that this DI box will work. So all I'm going to do is select my channels 1 and 2, and I am going to go ahead and press 48 volts, which will activate phantom power for this box. Now, the next thing that I need to do is just connect my device up to it. So I could either use my 1/8 inch to 1/8 inch, and I will just do that because that's how I normally do this. And once I have this connected, we can go ahead and press play. And we can see that we now have audio playing on my input 1 and 2. Now, again, because this is XLR, this can go hundreds of feet because of the nature of XLR, and no noise is going to be added in. So that's the benefit of having a direct box in line with your device, is it's going to integrate your playback music device into your X32 the best way. The other benefit of using a direct box is that on the direct box, there's typically going to be what's called a ground lift, which means if you hear a 60 cycle hum or a ground loop or a buzz, it's going to sound bzzz underneath the audio playing of your device. Now, if you have one of those ground loops, using a direct box is going to be the best way to isolate that and remove that ground loop. So if you have a computer that's plugged in, even if it's 5 feet away and there is a slight buzz, what you need to do is you need to go get yourself a direct box. And I have a bunch listed in the description of this video down below. And just install that in between your X32 and your music device, and that will remove that ground loop buzz that's happening. Now, I hope this video was helpful for you today. If you do happen to have any questions, make sure to post that in the comment section down below. Also, if there's a video that you're hoping that I would make, please put that down in the comment section down below, as I'm always reading through those comments to find videos that are going to be helpful for you. If you haven't already, make sure to check out my website at drewbrashler.com, where I have my X32 Fundamentals course, which teaches my favorite 5 fundamentals about the X32 and helps train you on how to use this better. So you can go check that out at drewbrashler.com. Otherwise, I hope you have a great day.